We all associate snow and hail with very stormy and wintry conditions, but what's the difference between them and how exactly do they form? Even in the middle of December, it's very difficult to forecast snow, but I'm going to explain exactly how snow and hail form. Snow is classed as a solid precipitation and occurs in a variety of minute ice crystals at temperatures well below freezing. We get larger snowflakes as we see temperatures get closer to 0 degrees Celsius.
Snow forms when tiny ice crystals in clouds stick together to become snowflakes. These ice crystals have to have something to hold onto in order to form. This is called a condensation nucleus and is usually a grain of sand or dirt. Once the ice crystal has something to hold onto, it can become heavy enough to fall to the ground.
Snowflakes, which fall through moist air, which is close to 0 degrees Celsius, clump together and form large flakes of snow. Snowflakes which fall through cold, drier air become powdery and don't stick together. When wind is associated with heavy snowfall, we get blizzards and drifts. But what about sleet? Is that similar to snow?
Sleet is also known as ice pellets and is usually smaller than hail. Ice pellets form in stratus clouds when snowflakes start to melt as they fall from the cloud. As they fall through sub-freezing air, they refreeze into grain-like particles.
So how is hail different to sleet? Well, hail is a shower of round or irregularly shaped pieces of ice, which form in a cumulonimbus cloud.
They start off as small ice particles or frozen raindrops that are caught in the updraft of air inside the cloud. As they ascend, they grow by gathering water on their surface. How big they grow depends on how strong and extensive the updraft is and how much water is in the cloud. In vigorous clouds, the hailstones may go up and down a number of times, adding a layer of ice each time.
Eventually, the hailstones become so heavy they can't be supported by the updrafts in the cloud and they fall to the ground. Some hailstones can be up to 6 inches in diameter and can cause damage to property and to crops. So the next time you're caught in a hail shower or messing around in the snow, have a think about where they came from high up in the clouds.